This is a Friday Shoes production. This is lesson 2-6 in our book on page 114. The target is I can add and subtract unlike fractions. Unlike fractions are fractions that do not have the same denominator. The bottom the fractions are different. We've already worked with like fractions. Those are easy. Once the bottoms are the same, all you do is add or subtract the tops. So that's what we're actually going to do here. We're going to change the fractions that are given to us, and we're going to convert them into fractions that are like. So let's take a look at number one. 1/4 plus negative 2/3. The bottoms are not the same. We need to convert the fractions into fractions that have the same denominator, the same bottom. One way to do that, and one way I see success here, is to find a denominator that works, you can multiply the bottoms and use that and then add the tops and everything would be great, except you might have to reduce at the end. Sometimes that's the best way to do it. If you have some skill and you've worked with finding the lowest common multiple between a number, then you have easier time when it comes down to reducing. But here's one way to do this. To find out what number is going to be on the bottom, and I already know it's 12. I'm just going to tell you that right now. 4 and 3, I just know. 3 and 4, the smallest number that both those go into is 12. The way to find that is, take the small number on the bottom, take the big number on the bottom of the fraction. Now see if the small number goes into the big number evenly, without any leftovers. 3 doesn't go into 4. So now double the bigger number, and see if 3 goes into 8 without any leftovers. It's called evenly. So does 3 go into 8 evenly? No, it doesn't. Then triple, make another 4 added on. Now you have 12. Does 3 go into 12 evenly without any leftovers? It sure does. It goes in there 4 times, actually. So 12 will actually be our bottom. So I need to convert our fractions, 1/4 and negative 2/3, into 12ths. Well, how do I change this 4 right here into a 12? Well, I multiply by 3. Well, that means I have to take the top times 3. Remember, if you change the bottom of a fraction, you're going to have to change the top of the fraction as well using the same multiplier. So I multiplied by 3. That's going to be 3 on top. Over here we have, and I always like to take this negative and put it on the top, we have negative 2/3. How do we change this 3 to a 12? We multiplied by 4. 3 times 4 is 12. We have to multiply the top then by 4. What's negative 2 times 4? That's negative 8. And now we're just going to add those together. When you add those together, you get negative 5 twelfths. You do not add the bottoms, and that's one thing that a lot of kids will try to do. They'll go 12 plus 12 is 24. Well, if you remember from like fractions, we don't actually add the bottoms. We just add the tops. You're talking twelfths. Think of it as you're counting things. I've got twelfths. How many twelfths do I have? Well, I have 3 twelfths and negative 8 twelfths. At the end, I have negative 5 twelfths. You don't change that bottom there. All right. How about you give it a shot on a couple of these right down here at the bottom? Pause the video. Do these two. Come on back. See how you do. Negative 5 sixths plus negative 1 half. First of all, I'm going to write it like this. Negative 5 sixths plus negative 1 half. I like to put the negatives on the top. Next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to check 2 to see if it goes into 6 evenly. Does 2 go into 6 evenly? It sure does, actually, 3 times. So 6 will be our common denominator. Now, I'm going to rewrite everything here with 6 on the bottom. Now, I notice that this 5, 6 is not going to change. The negative 5, 6 is going to change because it already has a 6 on the bottom. But the 2 doesn't. Therefore, I got to change that 2 into a 6 somehow, and I know it's by multiplying by 3. So I have to multiply the top by 3, and that will become to negative 3. Now, of course, we add those together, just the tops, and you have negative 8 on top. Keep the bottom the same. That doesn't change. And then from here, we'll have to change this into a mixed number, which is negative 1 and 2 sixths, which we've practiced before. And 2 sixths can be reduced to 1/3. By dividing by 2. So the final answer will be negative 1 and 1/3. And over here with the negative 5 sixteenths plus the 3 tenths. Again, I'm going to rewrite it so that the negative is on the top. I can't add these together yet because they do not have a common denominator. All right. Does 10 go go into 16 evenly without any leftovers. No, it doesn't. So 16 is not going to be it. Double 16, that's 32. Does 10 go into 32 evenly? No, there's leftovers. Put another 16 to it. It'll be 48. That's 40. Does 10 go into 48? No. Add another 16. Let's see here. That's going to be 64. Does 10 go into 64? No. All right. Add another 16. That's going to be 80. Does 10 go into 80? Oh, we have a winner. There it is. So 80 will be our bottom of the fraction. And how many times did 16, do we need to do this with 16 to get to 80? That's times 5. So since we multiplied this bottom by 5, 16 times 5 is 80. So you can see that's where we got this. Now we have to take the top times 5. So 5 times negative 5 is negative 25. And then over on the right side, 10 times what gives you 80? Well, 8. So I have to multiply the top by 8, and that's 24. Put our plus in between, add those together. Negative 25 80ths plus 24 80ths is negative 1 80th. All you have to do is add the top parts. And there is your final answer. All right, how about adding and subtracting mixed numbers? This gets a little busier. So they say find negative 6 and 2 ninths plus 4 and 5 sixths, and then write it in simplest form, which means reduce it. Well, step one, take these numbers and convert them into improper fractions. 9 times 6 plus 2, that gives you the 56 over the 9. Put a negative on it. And the second one, 6 times 4 plus 5 is 29 over 6. Excuse me. Next step is finding the common denominator. Excuse me. Now, if you notice, 9 and 6, the common denominator between 9 and 6 is going to be 18. You can do the same thing that I did before, 6 and 9. Does 6 go into 9 evenly? No. Does 6 go into 18? Yes, it does. Therefore, 18 will be it. Now, they've shown you what to do. You multiply the tops and bottom by 2 on the first fraction, then by 3 on the second fraction. And from there, you're going to add the tops. And when you add negative 112, notice there's where they put up the negative. Negative 112 plus 87 all over 80 or 18 is going to be negative 25 over 18. Or if you reduce that and change that to a mixed number, it's going to be negative 1 and 7 18ths. Same process. We just have to convert them into improper fractions, then work with them. And when you do that, some of these become larger numbers, but you shouldn't be too concerned by that. All right, let's practice a couple of these. Go ahead and pause the video and come on back, see how you did. All right, step one, convert these to improper fractions. This first one, 2 times 3 plus 1, that's 7 over 2. I'm going to put the negative on top already. 3 times 8 plus 1, 25 over 3. Bottoms are not the same, so we have to find out what is going to be the common denominator. Well, 2 doesn't go into 3 evenly, so it's not 3. Double 3, you got 6. Does 2 go into 6? Yeah, it does. So 6 is going to be a common denominator. So we got 6. We got 6. How did we change that 2 right there into a 6? We multiplied it by 3. So we take the top times 3. That's negative 21. How about down here? How did we change that 3 right there into a 6? We multiplied it by 2. So 2 times 25 is 50. Of course, we're adding those together. And when you take 21 plus 50, you get 29, and 29 over 6 is your answer, but we have to convert it into a mixed number now. How many 6s go into 29 without going over? Well, I know that's 4. That gets you to 24, and that's 5 away from 29. 5 will be your remainder. Always put your denominator on your mixed number fraction part. There it is. 4 and 5 sixths is the answer. Next one. 2 and 3 fourths minus 6 and 1 third. All right, convert to improper fraction. 4 times 2 plus 3 is 11 over 4 minus, and then we have 3 times 6 plus 1, that's going to be 19 over 3. There we have it. I like to change these into addition problems, so I do that. If you remember, that's the add, the opposite property. And now 4 and 3, they don't They're not the same, so we have to find the common denominator. All right, 3 doesn't go into 4. 3 doesn't go into 8. 3 does go into 12, though, so 12 will be our common denominator. We've done this one before. You've seen me work with 4 and 3 earlier on an example. So how do we change the 4 to a 12? We take it, multiply it by 3. So you got to take the top, multiply it by 3. How do we change the 3 to a 12 over here? We multiply it by 4. So we got to multiply the top by 4. When you take 4 times 19, I like to do 4 times 20 and then subtract off 4. So it's going to be 76. It has a negative on it. Then you add those together. Remember, the bottom doesn't change. That's going to be 12. But the top, you take your 76 that's negative and add it with a positive 33. That means you actually take 76 minus 33, and that's going to be 43. And because this one has a greater absolute value, it'll be a negative. So it's negative 43 over 12. Of course, we can't leave it like that. We have to write it as a mixed number. How many 12s go into 43? 3 of them. And it's going to be negative because of this negative right here. So I'm going to put that out in front. So we have 3 12s go in there. That makes 36. 36 is how far away from 43? That's 7. That's 7 remainder. And we put our 12, always have that same number down there. So we have negative 3 and 7 12s. All right, check this one out. This is just a test example. It says 4 students volunteered to work at an animal shelter after school. They worked 2 and 1/3 hours, 1 and 5/6 hours, 2 and 1/4 hours, and 1 and 7/8 hours. How much time did the students volunteer in all? Here's a test tip for you. Use estimation on some of these problems. It says if a test question would take an excessive amount of time to work, try estimating the answer, then look for the appropriate answer choice. So take a look at this. What are we really looking for? We need to add all these numbers up to figure out how many hours they totally worked, right? So they call it the sum. You have to add them up. Now, here's the easy part. If you really look at this problem, it says if you would take some time to change each of the fractions to one with a common denominator, it's going to take a while. However, notice that all 4 of the numbers have a value of about 2. 2 and 1/3, really close to 2. 1 and 5/6. That's almost like 1 in 6/6. That's really close to 2. Same with 2 and 1/4 and 1 in 7/8. They're all close to 2. So you got 4 numbers close to 2. Multiply those. You got 4 times 2, which is 8. Basically, if you added all those up, it's going to be close to 8. Look at the answer for B. It's the only one that's really close to 8. So I would take a guess as an estimation that it's going to be B. And guess what? That's what it is. How about you try that on this problem right here? It says Amanda is planting a rectangular vegetable garden using a roll of border fencing that is 45 3/4 feet long. If she makes the width of the garden 10.5 feet, what must be the length? What must the length be? Well, real simple. I like draw pictures on these types of problems. They said that the width is going to be about 10.5 feet. 10.5 feet. Well, that means this is going to be about 10.5 feet, and they want to know what the length is. I don't know what the length is here. We have to figure that out. We've got 45 feet total, and 3/4, I should say. But aren't these numbers really close to just like 10? Like, this 10.5 really could be estimated at 10, and same with this side over here at 10. And then we need to figure out 2 numbers added up together with the 2 tens to get you to 45 3/4, or really close to 45. So I've got 10 and 10, and then I got 2 other numbers. I'll just call them X. I don't know what they are. All right. Let's do this. I'll call them L because that's what I called them up there. All right. So what would it be? These would be 20, and I got to get to 45, close to it, and I got some left over here to figure this out. Well, how much more do I need to get to 45? Well, I need 25, don't I? 20 and 25 make the 45, right? So both of these got to be close to whatever half of 25 is. So cut half of 25. What is that? Well, you do that in your head, maybe. It's 12.5. So that's what I would look for. Is anything close to 12.5? Well, God, only one of them is really close to 12.5. So there's your final answer. Don't forget, you can always go back and watch these videos over again or read the examples in the book. And, of course, you have the personal tutors on the online textbook. This has been a Friday Shoes production.